That's all. And besides, you're trying to prepare. William, have a seat, please. All right, number one. Number one is exterior angle. Now, I gave you a formula that you have to know for the exterior angle. And most kids do it this way. They take the angle, and then they subtract and get that one, and then they figure it out some kind of way like that. But on this one, the exterior angle is equal to these two. So in your test, you should have A plus B. Any questions on what I just said? The formula I gave you, let me say it again. The formula I gave you was the exterior angle is equal to the remote plus the remote. Now, some kids chose not to remember that formula, but that's what they're asking for. Is everybody clear on this? The exterior angle is equal to the remote plus the remote. Yes? If you put 180 minus C, right, but the problem with that is it's going to be multiple choice, and that wasn't one of the choices. So you got to know what I just told you. Okay? A plus B. Is everybody clear on what I'm saying? I mean, it's one thing if you can supply your own answer, because maybe there could be different answers, or writing an answer a different way. But on this one, it's A plus B. It's a choice. All right, next one. The exterior measure of a regular polygon is what it should say, is 18 degrees. So let's just draw a figure. So draw this pentagon. Draw that pentagon. And then, just for the heck of it, put 18 degrees out here. We don't know how many sides this thing has. So the way you do it is, all exterior angles add up to 360 degrees, no matter what. The interior angles is n minus 2 times 180. You need to memorize that. But we're talking exterior. So no matter how many sides you have for the exterior, they're limited by 360. So you take 360 divided by 18. And that's going to give you your answer. How much is that?
20.
So 20 sides would be the answer for this one. But again, you got to know that all the exteriors will only be 360. Nothing more, nothing less.
And then you divide it by the angle that they give you.
Exactly. If it's an exterior. If they give you an interior, then you're going to plug it into this formula right here. All right, next. The slope of AB and BC. We did slope yesterday. But to do it, you would take AB, which is over 1 up 2. And then the other point is over 3 up 4. And then you got to find the slope here. And then you got to go BC. Well, B is 3, 4, but C is over 5 up 2. So first of all, you got to be able to find the points. And there are some of you that may have trouble finding the points. If you do, you don't have a chance. But here are the points here. Now, you got to find slope. So this one is 4 minus 2 is 2. 3 minus 1 is 2. So the slope is 1 for that one. 1 over 1. This one is 2 minus 4. Well, 2 minus 4 is a negative 2. And 5 minus 3 is going to give me 2. So what I get here is a negative 1. Now, I think I said, what do you get if, I should have put, what do you get if you multiply? If you multiply. That's called product, by the way, when you multiply. So if you take 1 times negative 1, you get negative 1. That means the lines are perpendicular. That's what I'm trying to get across. Since the slopes, when you multiply the slopes together, you get a negative 1. That means the lines are perpendicular. They come in at exactly 90 degrees. Write that down and try to memorize what I'm telling you. If you multiply the slopes and you get negative 1, they're perpendicular. If you multiply the slopes and you don't get negative 1, they are not perpendicular. They can look perpendicular all they want, but this tells you the truth right here. Any questions on that particular problem, number 3? The way they worded it was, if you do the product of both slopes, what do you get, basically? Or they say, do you get negative 1? But you got to know that if you multiply them and you get negative 1, they're perpendicular. That's the implication. Number 4. Number 4 says, this one right here, I should have indicated that they're parallel. So put some lines on here. Because if they're not parallel, we can't find anything. So on your diagram, put parallel. All right, now look up here. If this one right here, if they're all parallel, and this one is 50, corresponding angle says this one's 50, top, top. You were taught top, top. It may not be the one you want, but sometimes moving stuff around helps you find the one you want. This one right here would be top, top. So this one would be 50 also. Or top, top, bottom, bottom, however you want to think about it. This one would be top, top from here to here. This one would be 130 because they're supplementary. Remember, every line has to add up to 180. So if this one is 50, supplementary means it has to be 130 to get 180. Is everybody clear on what I'm saying? Okay, this is... Say it again?
The 50 all the way to the right.
This one?
No, up one. Yeah, what about that 50?
It's the same as that one. It's top, top.
No, no, but I'm saying, like, it's not going to be considered the part of the first line that goes straight across. Because it would be 50 and 50. That angle would only be 80 then instead of 130.
No, this one right here would... Are you talking about that one?
No, I'm talking about the 130, but I'm saying if you add the 50 and the 50 together...
They're separate.
Yeah.
What did you say?
They're separate. Like, you do it separately.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to, like, figure out. Cause, like, I would look at that and think to add 50 and 50, and then the other angle would be 80.
No, you only do, like, the angles on, like, that are sharing that line that goes in the other thing.
The angles that are sharing the line. For example, if you take this line right here and this line right here are parallel, you just block all this other stuff out. And this one right here is your transversal. And you only focus on this diagram, so it's top, top.
Okay?
Don't confuse this line and then go over to that one, because you can't cross like that. You can go from here to here if you just block that one out.
That's how he's saying. He's saying, like, see how, look at him? See how it's 130, and then there's the 50, and that's supplementary. And then there's the other angle that's would be 130 and the 50, and that's supplementary. He's saying, why wouldn't you add all of those together? Like, why are they two separate?
Okay, so you're saying add all four of these?
Yeah,
but I didn't know there was that fourth angle. I thought there was just the three.
All right, but you're okay now?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Because I'm still not clear on what you're saying, but no, you wouldn't add all four.
Yeah, I didn't know that those were the, they were only talking about that, the two angles first.
All right, look up here. Write this down. The bigger the angle, the bigger the side. It makes sense. If the angle is bigger, the side is bigger. And the converse is true. The bigger the side, the bigger the angle. Write that down and memorize that. So look up here. This one has a big angle. This one has a small angle. So that would mean this side right here would be bigger than that side. The bigger the angle, the bigger the side. The smaller the angle, the smaller the side. Is everybody clear on what I'm saying? X has to be greater than Y. That's what you're looking for. That's your answer. All right, next. This one right here looks like pure trig. They give you X is 7. So put 7 right here. and we need to work it. So watch and look up here. If I stand right here, I'm going to do opposite over adjacent. This is the hypotenuse. Opposite over adjacent is tangent. So it's going to be the tangent of 30 degrees equals opposite over adjacent. Any questions so far? You have to be able to do trig. There's more than just what I'm showing you on trig. I'm just giving you a few. All right, cross multiply. You're going to get y times the tangent of 30 is equal to 7. Then you're going to divide by the tangent of 30. So clear your calculator. We're going to work this one. Now on this black one, which you're going to be forced to use, look up here. You would take 7 divided by open parentheses. It looks weird, but this is the way you do it. And then 30, press tangent, close parentheses, and press equals. It's 12.1. If you didn't get 12.1, you need to... All right, watch again. Clear your calculator. Press 7 divided by open parentheses right here. And then press 30. And then press tangent, close parentheses, press equals. Did you get it?
Yeah.
All right. And then you got to do Z. Well, Z is going to be opposite over hypotenuse. Well, that's sine. So that's the sine of 30 degrees equals opposite over hypotenuse. So everybody clear on what I'm saying? You got to be able to do trig. So switch these two. So your answer is Z is equal to 7 over the sine of 30. Clear your calculator. Press 7 divided by open parentheses, 30, and then sine, and then close parentheses. I get 14 for this one. Any questions on how to do the trig?
You got 13?
I got 14. All right, the next one, convert. The reason why I'm making you convert is because it's multiple choice. If they write the answer like this and you don't know how to convert it, you're going to miss it. So clear your calculator. You got to work backwards. Press the square root of 3. So on this black one, you got to do clear. You have to press 3, shift, and then square root right here. I get 1.7. But then you got to multiply by 14 times 14. The answer on the test is 24.2. Any questions on how to do the conversion? You know what I'm talking about. If they give you answers, work backwards. I mean, you got to be smart, and working backwards is a smart way to do it. What is vertices? What's a generic name for vertices? Anybody know? Some of you are not looking. It's like you're looking everywhere else, but right here. What are vertices? It's points. So this one's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 points. You either know it or you don't. Edges. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Bless you. 9 edges. Faces. Excuse me? The edges are these creases, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 7, 8, 9. You with me? All right, the faces are the flat parts. So look here. You have 2 triangles, so that's a face, and then you got 3 rectangles, 1, 1, 1, so that's 3, 4, 5. You have 5 faces. Name the figure. It is a triangular prism, a triangular prism. If the bases are the same, it's called a prism. If it goes to a point, it's called a pyramid. All right, we got a little bit more time. Number 9. Distance formula. I'm not going to sit here and waste your time with distance formula, but that's what that is. Remember, if you can't write the point, you can't work the problem. So don't mess up on the point. This one is 0, 4. This one is 3, negative 2. 0, 4, and 3, negative 2. And then do the distance. look up here, find the volume of the box, and then figure the volume of half of a box that size. Volume is length times width times height. Don't miss that. That is so simple. So get your calculator. 12 times 8 times 6. I get 576 square, or cubic rather, something. Now let's cut the box in half. What's half of this 12?
6.
What's half of the 8?
4.
What's half of the 6?
3.
Clear your calculator. 6 times 4 times 3. I get 72 cubic inches. If I cut the sides in half, it doesn't cut the volume in half. Listen to what I'm saying now.
So why did you cut it in half?
Because the wording of the problem says, what if you had the sides half as big? Now look up here. All right, don't pack on me yet, guy. Take 576 divided by 72. It's 1/8 as big. The little bitty box is not half as big, it's 1/8 as big. In other words, it would take 8 of the little ones to equal the big one. All right, I'm going to pause the video here. You got to finish this tonight, though. Make sure you try.